Заходи, не задерживайся.
Подходи, сталкер. Для таких, как ты, у меня всегда есть кое-что интересное.
Поговори с барменом.
Business in the cordon. Gonna have to go through the garbage.
А, привет!
perks. Now that I got this power suit.
Здорово!
Areas completely controlled by the mercs, who have always been hostile to duty, the military, and even more recently, even the freelance loners, the free stalkers. And now, most recently in this playthrough, my faction, the Ecologists. Oh, duty have this checkpoint now. See, this is where I was. It was nighttime, and there was a bunch of merc snipers, like, in each window, and I had to use my night vision binocs to spot them one by one while moving positions around, laying down, and taking them out with the silence mauser. And then occasionally they would come down, and I circled around to get the ground forces. I took them out too. That shit was nuts. With my Thompson and my Mauser. But now duty's here. And they like me. So I don't need to worry about snipers. For now. But yeah. Alliance between mercs, anarchists, and bandits is becoming more concrete. I'm not really sure why. Oh, I got good grab resistance? No. Not as good as it could be. I'm not sure why the loners and mercs are at war with each other, other than competition for being freelancers for hire. You would think they would work together like the loners do with freedom and clear sky. Clear sky at war with the mercs too, I wonder. Clear sky. Our enemies with mercs, yes. Recently too. I guess by extension if they are with the ecologists, because yeah. Clear sky works very closely with loners and ecologists. It stands to reason. So far, far, I've been lucky. No mutants, no mercs. Might be able to just get over to my stash. No incident. Without any incident. God willing. Can't really sneak inside of this loud-ass armor. I'm gonna keep this stash where it is, because it's well hidden. The one that I want back is the one that's like right inside the Mercs camp, back when I used to work with them. Somebody died right here. Doesn't look like they had a PDA, so they must be mutants. If I can do a better approach on that. That was kind of dumb. I'm not very good at tactical games because my eyesight is kind of shit. Even looking at a screen, I'm just like having trouble making out one thing from another. If I look back at the recording, I probably didn't see him. Hindsight 2020. Okay, so then I need to take a different approach. And use the other way around. I don't really ever see them up there too often. I always figured I would eventually. Reconcile using third person is in my inventory. I have a telescopic mirror. Which is basically what I imagine I have when I play Fallout and I use third person to see around corners. I'm using a mirror. Threw a grenade.
Gonna make a big splash. This is gonna make a big splash.
Why are they throwing grenades? Forgot my new grenade button. Whoa! That was cool. Yeah, I switched to binds recently. Because I figured out there were some things conflicting. So now, grenades are 6, and not M. M is what my lamb button is on DXMP, so I add grenades to that. But for whatever reason, night vision for your binocs, I can't find it anywhere. It's M. But you can't rebind it, so now it's M. So I don't want that on the same level, conflicting with taking out grenades, so I make grenade back to 6, which was default, but getting used to that is kind of a bitch. I'm not gonna play well when I'm filming it, I already know. I heard I'm was using a silenced MP5 that I would switch between armor piercing, FMJ, and... Am I getting shot at? I am getting shot at. Chambered armor piercing. Okay, good. Oh shit. Zombies. Okay. Fuck. Okay. It's about to go down. Okay, now this is just cheating. Oh shit. What I get for coming over here. I think I'll let the stash go. I probably have to come from the other way anyway. It makes more sense to come from the other direction. From Yantar. Okay. So, I'm thinking... Load back. I don't think I lost anything. I just want to kind of get the lay of the land, but I don't think I can handle that wild territories. Even with the power armor, it's actually harder because you can't sprint. So getting used to power armor is like trying to fight with like a power recirculator instead of the speed enhancement Augin DXMP. It's like completely different. You need to be dug in a good defensive position. I think that's the only way. So instead, what I'll do is I'm going to go to the garbage. So basically, duty, since they have an outpost there at the flea market, they will escort you there, and that's how the fast travel works. And you pay them. I paid him like 9,500 rubles to take me there in a convoy, where you just kind of assume it's uneventful, and it saves you a lot of time walking around. But then once you get here, the shit goes down pretty much instantly.
Yeah.
Fighting bands. and that was the guy I had a contract out on, and somebody took him out for me, and I still get paid. Sometimes this game is a little... Oh shit! Doggos. I think I'll switch back to FMJ. Oh, I'm in FMJ already. Yeah, because I loaded back, okay. Oh wait, I'm not even loaded in. Perform maintenance on your gun, you detach all the attachments. So like the silencer and scope have to be reattached, and you have to reload because you unload it. Or you see, forget about that. Is that? Okay, that's a home. And he's dead. Damn. You can get killed by anything. Oh, those were cats, okay. Thought they were dogs. See, there's the duty outpost. This here's the flea market. Guess nobody else is gonna claim that loot. Oh, yeah. Well, that's why. Because they know the cats will come back as soon as you walk down there. Oh, he's going for it. He's going for the loot. Dogs and cats. Who'd have thunk that they would join forces? Is that guy wounded or dead? I think he's dead.
Отдыхаем.
Okay, the NPC has got the rest of this. Did he get this? Did they get this guy? Eric Gunpowder. Rip. Thanks for your shit. Fucked up, son. Happens to the best of us. Even me. Who this? Duty? Sergeant Walishima. Ooh, he had a bandit patch. This guy was a badass. Must have killed a bandit. I've killed plenty of bandits. Man, I hate not being able to sprint, though. That's kind of annoying. Ooh, here we go. A proper power supply. I'll take that and some batteries. Playboy and Maxim, of course. I need that for some quest, don't judge me. Also hold on to field cutlery because, you know, in my mind you have to have that on you because that's what you're eating with when you eat food. Okay. The power level too. Wait, does this have a battery in it? No. This does. Remove PSU? No. Remove suit. Attach patch. Favorite parts. Mark favorite. So then this doesn't have anything in there anymore. Supplies, bandages, I'm good on bandages, food, I'm good on food, water, so I'll have some shit I don't need. Beard's tea, sobers you, sleepiness reduction. For a quest, I guess. Okay, I'll take some of that. This apparently I need for quest. Does he have more of that? Nope, he's not carrying that. But the rest I'll keep. And I'll take some of that. Some of this and some of that. I save scum like crazy because this game is crash happy. It puts Bethesda to shame. Okay, it's buggier than Fallout. I gotta save, like, all the time. Also, I'm new. Give me a break. I'm a noob. Is that the sound it makes when you jump? That's freaky. So this is like the power armor in Fallout 4. It's in all the Fallouts, I know. Don't get mad. Okay, so... where was I going? Cordon? Yeah, I'm going to Cordon. I don't know if that's to collect or to... Uh-oh. Might be in a mission. Stop and check out my stash here. Is it a straight shot there without incident? Should I just fast travel? This is why I wish I could just sprint. Here's my stash. What does this do? Unpack this. This is not a banger. This is a pickup. A dead drop. I had to find this with like an RF signal. It was annoying. That saved me some weight. What the sparkler does. Kind of a fruity name for an artifact. Let's see. Sparkler. Sparkler does it. Doesn't look like it does much for me. Nah. Can I get anything for it? Probably because it's in terrible condition. Might as well stash it. Okay, here's the ammo they requested. Still not enough, huh? In this quest, they need a certain kit so that anarchists can pretty much disguise themselves as duty soldiers so they can go in and out of Rostock with impunity. But they need the perfect kit to pull it off. No idea if it's enough. How much do they need? was enough. He doesn't buy parts. Let's see if I can upgrade the suit more. I have upgrades, but now objective lens for the Binox. Oh, for more zoomage? What's this? More better night vision? That won't work? Oh, wait. You need historic weapon repair kit and the required tools. Well, I have this in the stash. Hopefully it doesn't require advanced tools. Otherwise, I'm not gonna be able to do it. So I'm upgrading Binox. Workshop missing the required tools. How come it's not telling me the tools I need? I mean, I have these, but it says I need something else too. It's kind of annoying. Usually it tells you what you're missing. Like, you need this for this. Okay, fair enough. I have this. Oh no, wait, for the Binox. I have basic tools. Historic weapon repair kit? That's what I need. Yeah. Use. No. The crafting system is kind of wonk in this game. Oh, I need like a special exoskeleton repair kit. Okay. But to upgrade the Binox, what else do I need? See, I have this. Yeah, historic weapon repair kit. I have this, the optical scope upgrade kit. But now I need one more thing. Required tools that they don't specify what they are. And apparently, I'm gonna assume that it's like, instead of a basic tools, you need advanced tool kit. That's probably it. They just forgot to say. Yeah, what a pain in the ass. I'm just gonna stash this stuff. I have two stashes. Because I'm a fucking kleptomaniacal hoarder. Okay. Don't judge me. Universal weapon cleaning kit. Never mind. Yeah. Wrong kind. Let's see. The mods away. Good, I'm under now. Good to go. Now, I think I'll stash the batteries, because I think now that I have the efficient power supply, it should last longer, so I only need one spare for now. Okay. Fast travel again, because I can warp here. That's the only other place you can warp to. Or you just warp to Cordon, but where's the fun in that? What is this place? Is that Meadow? Can you get there from here? Or you have to go to Corden? You have to go to Corden. And then you have to go all the way there to get to the meadow. Okay. Looks pretty good. Like I have like negligible made of wave particles coming from this thing, which I don't even think I need right now. Yeah, I'm good. I don't need that right now. Let's see, can I store it? Nice. Respawn times and the randomization RNG for squad types and sizes of different mutants. Oh, yep, and different stock or factions. So I should start seeing more varieties. I think for this, I can't justify being escorted by anybody to the cordon. The only people that go down there are the military, who are not here, but down there. And then the loners, who are all over, but they're not trying to spend their day holding your hand. So you're on your own for this part. That's the way I see it. They're right where I need to go. And I see those things. I don't want to give up the high ground just yet. Kitty. I hear kitties. I think they're called fractures, the ones I saw. The elongated arms and shit. What's that? Doggos. Where I need to go, too. I should match this control config for movement and crouching and proning and standing up fast for on Ghost Recon. Because I'm new to playing it on PC instead of Xbox. I feel there's some similarity here for how the controls function for standing up and going prone, etc. I think they might have already seen me. No? Oh, I missed. Did I miss again? When you're not streaming, I don't know, it's different. You just take your time, you're into it more. It's more immersive. I didn't even press anything. I clicked it once and it got stuck and just went full auto. Maybe I switched weapons too fast or something. Thank you. was but for barkeep. That was for that guy. Oh no, that was the meat for that guy. Okay, so when I come back around. Man, I knew streaming was gonna make me play badly. Oh, like my shots when I tried to snipe. And then switching too fast to the Thompson so that the trigger stuck. Wait, I wonder if that's an immersion thing. Is it because the trigger is damaged that the trigger stuck and went full auto like that? No, it's all in top condition. I think that might be an in-game bug. If you switch too fast, it just like... There's another weird thing that happens. Oh, I'm supposed to save. I don't know if I did that. There we go. That's what the fire's for. There's another weird bug that, like, if you're looting, or you're, like, in your inventory and you're trying to, like, transfer items or drop items you don't want anymore, when you exit out of the inventory menu, it does this weird thing where it's just, like, it thinks you're holding down the pickup button, so it just picks up everything that you just dropped instantly, because for whatever reason, it's, like, it's kind of like the same thing. It's, like, the trigger stuck. But it's like the action button stuck, even though you're not pressing it. This game still needs a lot of work. It's slav jank. But it's the best kind of slav jank. What the fuck? Did I crash? I think I crashed. GG. That's why I don't stream. Oh, no, we're good. Sometimes bandits hang out in here. Also set the anomalies to be dynamic so they can like randomize where they spawn, where they appear, like they move. There's some that don't move, but then there's some that do. Some of them are set though, like they are where they are. Definitely a fun game to play by yourself, but as far as streaming goes, I don't know. Like, even Operator Drewski's footage is like hours long, and he cuts it down to like an hour. But like, that's from like many, many hours, many days playing, and just like sorting the highlights. And that's a lot of editing too, and I just like, prefer to just feel immersed and not stream. I'm not even that good at this game, to be honest. I'm not very good. Especially when I'm streaming. I don't know, I get self-conscious or something, start playing like shit. But when it's just me, I don't know, it's nice. Zombies. can't underestimate them, dude. They fuck you up. They look all slow and stupid and shit, but then they're like sneaky. They form around you, and then all of a sudden they move fast. Effect you're seeing is not compression, that's like what radiation is said to actually look like when you can see it. Of course, when you can see the ionization of the air by gamma particles in real life, that means you're already fucked. Like, you're gonna die of cancer in like a week. Or just radiation poisoning within a few hours or something. See them too often. Just run right into fucking anomalies and die. Wait, is that? The helicopter's military, but this base I think is bandits. Yeah. Snort coming toward me. I don't know how it saw me. It was that far away. Maybe they can smell you through those gas masks. For miles. And they found somebody else. I hear them. Here's the homie base. Ben Rotwood. Sounds like a bandit. He died. Doesn't look like anyone picked up his PDA, so maybe there's loot over there.
Слушаю тебя.
Hey, what's up? This is a loner's outpost. The Free Stalkers. The original Stalkers. They did it before it was cool. These guys are the true neutrals. The only ones they're hostile with are the mercs and the bandits and the military because, well, because those guys shoot on sight. It's empty. It's got batteries. I wish I could customize the Thompson to have a silencer, but I don't think that's a thing. Not for Thompsons. They also have the 1921 model, the Tommy gun.
Чем тебе помочь?
Doesn't have the tools to do it either. Fuck. It's really hard to get advanced tools. Exciting part of the stream. What a thrill. I'm selling some shit. Uh-oh. Is it a mission or an ambush? Yeah, it's an mission. Side storms, they shall.
Найдешь какие детали для апгрейда? Подтаскивай, помозгуй.
I don't have any companions anymore, so I don't need to tell them. So like, there's always a chance that everyone in here is gonna shoot each other from like going crazy from the Zion mission. Kinda scary. Like outside now. What?
Да иди ты.
Usually there's like an aurora borealis, but I guess it's too foggy for that. Oh, there's all the people that died. Rip. They got fried. This is how it is. Son. That's how it is. Now. Next place I'm going. Oh. else is there? That's a bandit camp. But with a dead one that might have some loot. Nah, I don't need to bother with that, do I? Just go for the meadow. Find the missing unit. So the helicopter is still flying after that shit went down? Crazy bastards. I will not get into any kind of aircraft in this area if that shit went down. Size storms and shit. In it, but you'll you become a zombie too. Nothing but snorks in there. And the snorks are dead now. Don't see anyone else over there. Zombie. Is that it? Yeah. Looks clear. I really wish I could sprint in this thing. Because this just makes me want to abuse fast travel. I've only been to the meadow once, and it was like this. It was just to like do one mission there and then get out. But I had a squad last time, and there was a lot of mutants and bandits in there, so I'm kind of concerned for how dangerous this will be. Through anomalies, huh? I don't give a fuck. It only affects the player and mutants. I guess because it was too complicated to reconcile anomalies with their pathfinding. Mutants pathfinding is a bit more erratic, but also mutants being subject to anomalies is, I guess, a little more fair since they're so fast and deadly. And I guess they're saying that the stalkers are too smart to, like, run into an anomaly. I mean, you would think they would code the same sort of thing that makes stalkers be able to seek cover to, like, invert that so that they avoid anomalies. I don't know. It's like avoiding a grenade. I wouldn't think it would be that complicated to code. Sleepy boy.
Чуча, а?
Junior Sergeant Romanyev. You hear a guy yawn and then my guy yawns, makes him sleepy. Now we're both sleepy boys. Nah, I don't do deliveries. Tired of being over encumbered with other people's shit. I mean, shit, man. I think I might get rid of this, because ballistic protection is 6%. It's not even that good. Radiation resistant 2% on top of my 20, so 22% total. That's pretty good, actually. That's the best I've had so far with radiation resistance. Off here for streaming. And then I'll take a break and come back and play without it. It's, you know, it's fun to show off a game, but at the same time, it's like, you kind of gotta play this for yourself. So, this is just a little bit of Stalker Gamma. There's some bases here you can explore. There's a stash over here. Let me pick up that stash and then I'll end it. I wish it didn't yawn that often in intervals. It's like, just do it once when you reach level one of tiredness, and then when you reach the middle level, do it again, and then when you reach, like, the extreme level of exhaustion, then you can do it in regular intervals then, but, like, just do it once to announce that you've entered the first level of exhaustion. That's what I say. These motherfuckers don't listen to me. They're like, Kojak, you stupid. Shut up, Kojak. You don't know nothing about video games. Thank you. wasn't it. Oh, this is it right here. Ooh, damn, there's a lot of shit in there. Okay, this I don't need. I wish pressing the sprint button automatically centered your lean when you have toggle lean on. Just like pressing sprint automatically stands you up regardless of whether or not you're prone or crouched. So you don't have to go through like the... Instead, what it does is, like, when you're leaning, you're locked into this until you press that again. And if you press the wrong lean button, it just leans you the other direction and does the same, and you can't sprint. It prevents you from sprinting. Which I think is, shouldn't do that. Anyway, thanks for watching.